the British colonists around who we are benefiting, we're benefiting from their activities, they were already well advanced in dealing with, well, I'll quote, that hapless race of Native Americans, which we are exterminating with such merciless and felicitous cruelty. That's quoting John Quincy Adams, but many years after he had completed his own extremely gruesome contribution to these actions and was beginning to feel some penitence about them. His own particular actions are quite important historically. They include the first executive war in American history, the conquest of Florida, which is a typical modern-style executive war, like Kennedy's attack against South Vietnam, to refer to another thing that only existed in history, not in ideology. Conquest of Florida was in defense, John Quincy Adams explained. It was in defense against hordes of lawless Indians and Negroes who had fled to Florida, and we had to defend ourselves against them, so they carried out this monstrous war, the first Seminole War, which is now celebrated by the fact that Florida State, or one of those places, its motto is the Seminoles, which is kind of like the Jews and the Gypsies being the mottos for, Freiburg and Hamburg and so on. I should say one of the historians who's written about this mentioned that John Quincy Adams' favorite slogan was from Tacitus. It was the phrase, "Crime once exposed has no refuge but audacity." And that's a good slogan. And it's been used over and over again since John Quincy Adams justified that war of self-defense against the hordes of lawless Indians and Negroes. And I keep it in mind because that's one of the turning points. We're back to self-defense of that kind these days. I'll come back to that if there's time. As I say, Adams did recognize what had been done, the extermination of the hapless race of Native Americans. I'm sure you all know that around here anyway, since the commander-in-chief, Amherst, Lord Jeff, who was the highest authority in America, was also the person who initiated germ warfare. He was considered committed not to extermination, but rather to what he called extirpation of the natives. It was a little different. And giving smallpox blankets from the fort at Fort Pitt was his idea of how to extirpate them. Obviously that's taught in elementary schools here, so I don't have to go on with the story. Adam Smith was also talking about that. There's a name for that these days. It's called the North-South Divide. That's the result of the barbarian conquest that spread over the world, the North-South Division or something like that. Kind of sounds nice.